Hey guys, GeForce Ginger here. Today, we're going to install a pair of Aerocatch Extreme hood latches into a Seibon carbon fiber hood on the Honda Civic Type R. Stay tuned. These are the items that you're going to need for the install. A plastic drop cloth or tarp to protect your engine bay. A drill with a few various bits. A rotary tool with a sanding drum and cutting head. Painter's tape. Of course, your Aerocatch fasteners. A ruler. Some toothpaste or whiteout. Also a 10mm and 12mm socket with extensions. A 2.5mm Allen key. A 17mm wrench. A pair of scissors, a flathead screwdriver, a Sharpie, a pen, and a few sheets of paper. After you have popped your hood, remove the airbox. There's a 10mm bolt right here, and then one in the back. You'll need an extension to reach the one in the back because it actually hooks up to the side of your battery holder. Once you remove those screws, loosen this metal fastener, and then push the ring back, and then unclip this electrical connector right here. Place that to the side. And now the entire airbox is just gonna pop out. So grab it firmly until it pops. We'll have to wiggle it a little bit. There it goes. Now what I like to do is grab this hose and just push down really hard right here, right there, and it'll just come off. There we go. Now be very careful, you gotta take these plastic things off first. I just push them to the side and they come out. There we go, just those front ones, right? Now very carefully lift your airbox up and out of the car. Set that safely to the side. Next, we're going to remove this plastic shield right here. And to do that, just get a flathead screwdriver, a skinnier one, and you're gonna stick it very gently under the edge of one of these little tabs. Push down and towards the center of the pin. Once you feel you're at the center, you're gonna twist the screwdriver to the side, and then you hear it click. Now the mechanism is released, you can pull the fastener out. So you're gonna have one right here, right here, right here, 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 here. One by one, go ahead and remove all those. The next thing we're gonna do is mark our strike pin location. The first one is going to be right next to this warning sticker to the left of this bumper. So lift up so you can see the hole, make sure it's the right one, and just make some kind of mark in there so you know that that's the right hole, okay? The next hole location is actually over here where your airbox used to be. So if you'll see, there's two pieces of plastic that have holes in them that line up with the metal. So that hole right there, pull the plastic away, mark your hole. And now we can gently lift this entire plastic shield off the car. Next, we're going to remove the bolts found here, 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 and here. So, these middle two bolts are both going to be 10 millimeters. So take your 10 millimeter socket, loosen those up. And now, take your 12 millimeter socket and loosen the other two. The next step is to remove this metal bracket that we just took the bolts off of. So if you notice, the front part of your bumper is pretty flexible. What you're gonna wanna do is pull back on it, but not too hard, and make sure you clear the latch with a piece of metal. Sometimes it's easier to start on one end than the other. And then this whole piece comes right out. Set that safely to the side. The next step is to remove the two 12 millimeter bolts found here and here. Now we have two more 12 millimeter bolts to disconnect. They are directly adjacent to the ones we just removed. So there's one right here, and then on this side, it's gonna be right here. So I'm gonna pull the camera in right now so you can see what I'm talking about. All right, so we are on the passenger side. First thing you need to do is to remove this line right here. So I'm gonna press on these little plastic pieces and then push out in the line until it snaps. Be very careful. Now we have the line loose. Next thing you want to do is take your 10 millimeter socket, very carefully break it loose. It's right there. Okay. Now we can just loosen it by hand. Set that to the side. Once that bolt is out, go ahead and grab this whole beam and pick up, and then push this metal line away from this plastic piece. So we have it under this plastic piece now, and this whole top piece is loose. The next 12 millimeter bolt is now on the driver's side, directly across from the bolt we took out earlier. You're going to need an extension for this one. And it's straight down. It's the only bolt in there, so it's pretty easy to find. It comes straight in. So go ahead and break it loose. Here we go. Take it all the way out. Now this top piece is loose on this end too. It's exactly what we want. Now we're going to cut an inch off the end of both of our strike pins. So take a ruler, measure an inch off the end of the strike pin, and go ahead and cut that end piece off. Once you cut your pins, they should look like this. We're cutting 1 inch off the end. To install the strike pin on the driver's side, first thing you want to do is you want to go ahead and thread a nut all the way on there and a washer first. We have to make sure to put the strike pin through the hole that we labeled earlier. What we're going to do is take a piece of painter's tape, put a nut on there first, and then a washer. Now fold the sides in to hold everything in place. Once everything is nice and secure, we're going to pick up on this beam. Slowly slide your washer and nut in. Be very gentle. Line it up with a hole. Now pull your painter's tape back out. And then thread the bolt all the way down. Once it touches, go ahead and back up on the thread just a little bit. And then go ahead and tighten the top nut. Try to line the shroud up so that the washer presses on it evenly. There you go. Now we're going to repeat that process on the passenger side. Take your strike pin, go ahead and screw on one of the nuts, thread that all the way down. Okay, now we're gonna put a washer on there. There we go. And we have our hole that we marked earlier. Take a piece of painter's tape, now on that tape, you're going to lay flat the nut first, and then the washer, and then squunch up on the sides, the painter's tape, to hold the washer in place. Like so. Now, take your pin, first line up the washer and the nut with a hole. Okay, now thread it in there. Once you feel that you have some thread, you can go ahead and pull the tape away. Okay. Now, hold the nut steady while you screw the pin all the way down. Once the pin touches, you're gonna wanna back off a little bit. Now tighten this nut all the way down. Like so. Now what we want to do is to go ahead and measure the length of the passenger pin and get the driver's pin to about the same height. So we need to come up with it. So what I'm gonna do is lift up. Grab that nut a little bit, then unscrew it. Okay, let's get this, we got it about right. Tighten the nut again. And we're going to measure again. And then it's about the same. So, tighten these bolts just a little bit. Just going to be hand tight for now. Making sure that this beam is firmly in place. The next thing we want to do is go ahead and drop your hood and make sure that both of these strikes touch the hood at the same time. Lower the hood. That one's touching. And so is that one. So we're good to go. Go ahead and put your hood back up. Now we're gonna go ahead and bolt this down temporarily to make our cuts and make sure everything's lined up properly. So don't forget that these are gonna be 12s. There's two right here, and then one in the front. The bigger bolt goes in the rear right here. It's still 12, just slightly larger looking. And then the other 12 goes in the front. Thread those on there. Okay, same thing on the other side. The larger looking one goes over here. And then the smaller one goes right here. Okay, go ahead and tighten those down. Same thing on the other side. Tighten these down. Now we're gonna put the two 12s in the front. You gotta be careful with these not to lose the bolt. Now that we have this beam secured down, both of our pins are hand tight and about the same level. And also, when you shut the hood, both of your pins are touching whenever you shut the hood. You're ready for the next step. The next step is to take your toothpaste or whiteout, whatever you have, and you're gonna put a little dab on top of each pin and then gently shut your hood on top of it, and it should leave a mark exactly where your pin lines up with your hood. All right, here we are on the driver's side. Just a tiny little bit, just a dab is all you need. And now, the passenger side. Try to get right in the center. Don't put too much, just a little bit. There we go. The next step is to go ahead and gently shut your hood. And make sure that both the pins touch the underside of the hood. Shut the hood. Make sure both sides touch. Now lift the hood back up. As you can see, we have our marks right here and the other one right over there. Next, what you want to do is take your plastic sheeting or your tarp and go ahead and cover your engine bay. Make sure to leave these pins exposed. Just like that. Now what we want to do is take your drill and drill through just this first layer. We are not going all the way through the hood yet, just this first layer. And don't use too big of a bit. I'd say like a medium small bit. So grab firmly on the hood, hold it into place, and drill your hole. There we go. Just like that. Now what we're gonna do is take our rotary tool with a sanding drum and make this hole just big enough for the strike pin to fit through there. So now we're over here on the driver's side. Now I'm switching back to the sanding drum and I'm gonna widen the hole straight in. That way the pin can fit through it. just like that. Now what we're gonna do is clean up these holes, wipe all this dust off of here on both sides. And make sure you have enough toothpaste on the tip of each strike pin. I'm gonna put just a little bit more in each one. Now what you're gonna do is lower your hood down and your strike pins are gonna go through these holes that we just made. And they're gonna mark the underside of the top of the hood. Very gently lower your hood down. Make sure your holes are lining up on each side. Make sure they touched on both sides. Now we're back over here on the passenger side, and through our hole is our new mark from our toothpaste, from our pin. It went all the way through, and it's about the center. So I want to be very careful on this hole because now we're going through the top of the hood. So I'm going to use the rotary tool with a drill bit tip, and I'm going to start the hole very precisely in the center of my mark. The next step is to go ahead and lower the hood down and make sure that your strike pin lines up with the hole that we just made. Perfect. Okay, here we are on the driver's side. And I see my toothpaste mark. I have my Dremel with a drill bit tip. And I'm gonna drill right in the center of it. Once again, the next step is going to be to lower the hood and make sure that your pin lines up with your new hole. Perfect. The next step is to prop your hood up. I'm just using a bucket for this with something nice and sturdy. That way when we drill through the top, we don't stick the drill into the engine bay. Now what we're gonna do is drill our hole wide enough so the strike pin can fit through. Make sure you're going straight down with this, right in the center of the hole. Okay, now lower the hood and take a look at where your pin lines up with the hole. Now we're gonna take the rotary tool with a drum tip and we're gonna widen the hole just enough for the pin to stick through. So go ahead and raise your hood back up, prop it up. Now I have my rotary tool with a drum tip and I'm gonna very carefully widen this hole just enough for my strike pin to go through. Every now and then lower the hood and check to see what you got. Getting pretty close. Looks like I need to do this back corner. Now we drop the hood back down. And once it's lined up, it should look just like this. We have the pin going right to the center of our hole. Now we're going to repeat this process on the driver's side. Go ahead and prop your hood up. Find your hole. And we're gonna drill straight in. Now we're gonna drop the hood back down and see where the pin lines up, and then come back up. Okay. Now we're gonna take our rotary tool and make the necessary adjustments for a strike pin to get through. Every now and then lower the hood and see what you got. So I need just a little bit more in the backside. So I'm gonna hit it again just a little bit. Now I'm gonna lower it and see what I got. Okay, now here's the driver's side complete. I have the pin coming up right through the center of the hole. The instructions to make the stencil needed for installation can be found inside the packaging. Right here. So what you do is you take the back side of the fastener, lay it over a sheet of paper, then you're going to trace the inside and the outside and then mark the screw holes. And it should look something like that. I already have one completed right here. Now you need to mark the pin location. To get this center line, what I did was I cut the stencil out and then I folded it in half perfectly. And that gave me my x-axis. The y-axis, as said right here in the instructions, is actually 30 millimeters away from this back hole. So what I did was I lined up an edge on the x-axis with that hole, 30 millimeters, there's my x. So now you should have a finished stencil that looks exactly like this. Now what you're going to do is take your stencil and line up the hole with the dead center top of your strike pin. So what I like to do is lift one side up so I can see where my mark is at. Make sure it's directly over your pin, right in the center. Okay, now tape that end down and then check and see what you got. You need to be pretty precise right here. So I think I need to come back a little bit. So top, dead center, boom, just like that. What I like to do now is to get the bottom part of my fastener and line it up and make sure that it's sitting flat against the hood. These fasteners have to be sitting flat for them to get a good hold. You can't put it vertical because it rocks. It's not flat. So you want to have it facing inward. So I have the wider end towards the outside of the car, and then the skinnier end aiming in towards the center of the car. Also, get your rotation how you want it. Just as long as that center pin is right, you can rotate it and just feel where the flattest point is. I'm pretty close to it right now. Once you feel like you like where you got it, it's nice and flat, center pin's lined up, tape it down. Now it's very important that you have your strike pin on your stencil lined up perfectly top dead center of your strike pin. So do your absolute best to line that up perfectly. The next thing we're gonna do is go ahead and untape one side to make sure the other side is still taped down. Fold it back. And we're gonna start putting masking tape down from one end to the other. So it needs to start about right there. Okay, now once you get to the other side, what you're gonna do is retape the first side, push it nice and flat against your hood so you're not losing any adjustments. Now, untape this side from the stencil, and then finish putting down your masking tape. The next thing we're gonna wanna do is take a Sharpie and trace the outline of the stencil down onto the painter's tape. And then lift tape off of one side very gently. Be careful not to rip your stencil. Make sure that you're not moving your stencil. Once that side's done, I'm gonna put my tape back down, move to the other side, very gently take off my tape, make sure everything's lined up absolutely perfect, and then trace this other side. Okay, now we can take off our stencil completely. The next step is to take the inside of your latch and lay it flat on your hood where it lines up absolutely perfect. Once you have it lined up, what you're gonna do is take a pen and trace that inside edge, because the inside edge is where we're gonna cut. So get this lined up to the absolute best of your ability. Once you got it where you like it, take a pen, mark the inside, and try to make this a pretty dark mark, because you're gonna need to follow this as you make your cut. Okay? Now what we do is take the inside of the fastener, line it up. Once you got it where you like it, we're gonna mark the drill holes. Okay, just look about like that. The next step is to go ahead and pop your hood again. And now what I'm doing here is I'm taking a towel that's balled up, placing it under the hood near where I'm gonna make my cut. And that'll give me some support to make my cut without having to worry about going into my engine bay. Make sure that's nice and firm. So before we make our cuts, make sure that you have a dusting mask and some safety goggles on. And what I'm gonna do is take my rotary tool with my cutting wheel, and I'm not gonna get really close to the line. I'm just gonna do a rough cut on the inside of this. Give yourself plenty of space because we're cutting along this inside line, and we're gonna finish it off with a sanding drum. So you don't have to get close. We're just trying to get most of the inside out. Okay, once you got your piece loose, go ahead and pull it out. Clean up what you got. And now we're gonna finish the rest off with a sanding drum. Okay, now I have my sanding drum, which is this bit right here. Go ahead and mount it on your rotary tool. And very carefully, slowly work your way to the line. Hold this thing with two hands. Every now and then stop to see where you're at. Refine your line. Once you think that you've got pretty close, what you want to do is take your latch and line it up, see if it fits. If it doesn't fit, take the retainer to your latch, overlap, and now you should see where you need to make cuts. Line up all your screw holes, find your spots that need to be trimmed, and go ahead and trim it some more. Nice and snug. So if you'll notice, on the driver's side, the fastener doesn't go all the way down. This is because we need to trim the underside of the hood. So we're gonna do that right now. Go ahead and lift your hood back up. And what we're gonna do is make a rough cut just to this bottom layer that completely outlines where we have our fastener on the top. And the hole that we make, we need to be able to fit this fastener through there. So what I like to do is to just kind of guess where we think that's gonna be, and then make some marks on the sides, on the top and the bottom. Now we aren't cutting this out exactly, we're actually gonna be cutting a bit wider than that. So now what you're gonna do is take your rotary tool with a cutting wheel and very carefully cut a little bit wider than the marks you just made. Now it's really thin right here to the top layer of the hood, so you need to be really careful when you cut through. As you can see now, we have access to the bottom side. We're gonna take a sanding drum and smooth all that out right now. Now lower your hood back down. See if your latch lines up. It should sit flat now. Make sure it's snug. We're gonna take a pen and we're gonna mark the drill holes more precisely. So what you wanna do is trace the circle on the inside on each hole. Here we go. So now we have our drill holes. To drill the holes, I prefer to use a rotary tool with a little miniature drill bit on top. And what you're gonna wanna do is one by one, drill each one of your holes. And then take the mounting screw and make sure that it goes straight into the hood through your hole perfectly. You don't want it going in at an angle in any other direction, just flat straight into the hood. So, here we go. Thank you. Once we have all the holes drilled, we can remove the tape. Okay, now we're gonna go ahead and clean up the underside. So go ahead and pop each one of the nuts into the hole on the backside of your retainer. And you're gonna put the locking part out. They just pop in and then it holds them in place. That way you don't gotta worry about them falling out. And what you wanna do for this next step is you're gonna hold in place the bottom of your fastener with the bolts already stuck into the backside as you bolt it in from the top. Now you're gonna take all six of your screws and thread them in through the top piece all the way into the bottom. So you gotta hold it to where it lines up. Take your 2.5 millimeter Allen key. And so don't tighten these up all the way. Just get each one started all the way around. We want to make sure everything lines up. Okay, now that you have all your bolts threaded, we're gonna start to tighten them up. So I like to go in a star pattern. So here, 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 here. So first we're just gonna snug them up. Okay, once you're confident those are all going in clean, we can go ahead and tighten it up. So these don't need to be crazy tight because these are locking nuts. But you do want it to be in there pretty good. Okay, now we're gonna go through them one last time and just make sure they're all evenly tight. Okay, that should be good. So that latches on there. Okay, now we can go ahead and open our latch and remove our towel. And what we're going to want to do is push our pin through the hole. Go ahead and shut the hood. And you want to check your pin adjustment. Check your height. So it looks like mine is just a little bit too high. So what I'm going to do is reopen the hood. Now I'm going to adjust that pin. Okay, so to adjust the pin, we're just gonna pull this whole piece up, loosen the nuts, and adjust it accordingly. I need it to come down a little bit, so I'm gonna turn it down. And make sure that you have your pin lined up parallel with the car, facing this way. Okay. Go ahead and shut your hood and see if it lines up. Once you get the pin aligned, go ahead and shut your hood all the way. And this is what proper pin alignment should look like. You should be able to freely engage it into the pin, nice and smooth. So it goes in, clicks, and then it's in, and then open it back up. So it shouldn't be in a bind at all. If you have to, adjust the height. Once you got it, both sides should go in freely with no problem at all when your hood is shut. Once you have your height adjusted, go ahead and open your hood again. Now we're going to take a 17 millimeter wrench and then get a screwdriver to hold the position of the pin. And then we're going to tighten it down. Check one final time that your hood pin still lines up and latches freely. So I drop the hood, close the pin, perfect. Now this is how you line up the other side. So what you're gonna do is take a piece of cardboard and trim it to match the body of your car. So I have it matching the hood right here. That way I can line it up with this edge, nice and perfect. And then I cut it to match the exact outline of the Aerocatch fastener. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna flip this over and then take it to the other side. And then now to line up my second fastener so it's exactly like the other side, all you have to do is make sure your strike pin is lined up perfectly and then use this stencil. That way you have an exact mirror on both sides. And just make sure that your strike pin is lined up perfectly dead center top. And that's how you get both sides to match. Now I have some detail spray and I'm just cleaning up the underside of the hood. This is the point where you can tape these holes shut if you prefer. I actually like the way it looks. I rounded out my edges and made everything look clean. Same thing with the other side. But if you want to tape it now. Okay, now we need to carefully fold this plastic in towards the center of the engine. You don't want to get any of this stuff loose in your engine base, so be very careful that you don't dump any of this stuff in your engine bay. And then remove that plastic. Now before we reassemble the engine bay, now is a good time to go ahead and detail all these spots that you can't normally see or reach. Reassemble the engine bay in reverse order of how we took it apart. Okay. Now before we reinstall this plastic piece, we're gonna have to take our Dremel tool with a drum and widen these holes, that way our pin can fit through. So I'm gonna put a towel down. That way I get nothing in the engine bay. Now what I'm gonna do is take my rotary tool and just widen this hole just a little bit with the sanding drum. See if we give it enough. Perfect. Okay, repeat that process on the driver's side. Protect your engine bay with a towel. And it's gonna be this hole right here that we need to widen. Take your rotary tool. Check and see what we got. Perfect. So carefully remove the towel. Make sure that you don't get any bits of stuff in your engine. Here we go. Once we have our holes made for our strike pins, we can go ahead and put the shroud back on top. Now we're going to cut about a quarter inch off of each bumper. So just take some scissors. There goes one side. Push it on all the way over the top. All the way down. Now we're going to cut a quarter inch off of this side. And put the bumper all the way down. And then test the hood one more time to make sure that it shuts correctly. Perfect. Perfect. Now we're going to take all of our plastic fasteners. Make sure that when you're doing these, you have them pulled out before you insert them. And they should snap into place. Pull it out. Snap it in place. Now we're going to reinstall the airbox. Now I'm gonna blow some of this dust out of here. And now, for the very last time, make sure your hood shuts. Perfect. Once you have your hood shut for the final time, go ahead and wash your whole car. Give it a good rinse first to get all those particles off and wash everything down. And then that's it. That is the full install of the Aerocatch panel fasteners on a Seibon carbon fiber hood for a Honda Civic Type R FK8. Please let me know if you have any questions at all. I'm gonna do my best to help all of you guys out. Thanks for watching, and good luck.